What's good, Overtime Podcast listeners? We're a little late to the party this week. It is Thursday. It's not a Friday or a Wednesday. Jesus, Lord. See, I'm already a week or a day ahead. We had some complications yesterday of me being really freaking tired and working my ass off. So what happens, just long story short here. When you work in the cold and you come home and it's warm in your house, guess what you do? You kind of just fall asleep because you're really tired. So, I just want to apologize that it was not live yesterday, and we're kind of going to fly through it. Not like we did last week, because obviously you see Alex is feeling 10 times better.
Yeah.
So, let's get right into it. We're going to go over the first... firstly, I guess we're going to go over the games from last week. Again, we're not going to try to make this super quick, but we're going to make it quick. And we are eating. Because again, this is Overtime Podcast, and we have to eat too. So, let's get into it. So... Alex, do you even have our record from last week?
No. I didn't do picks last week, though.
That's right, because she was tired. I think I did do picks, though. So, what we'll do is we'll skip that for now. But, Alex, we'll have to go back and probably listen to what I picked.
That's fine.
Or just go to my DraftKings.
Yeah, I can probably just do that, yeah.
Actually, fun fact, guys, I don't think you can go to my DraftKings, Alex, because the bet that I tried to place last week, I don't think placed.
Oh!
So, I had a bet, but for some reason didn't place, so...
Huh.
YouTube, sorry about that. It's alright, because I got $5 for this week to bet now. But alright, let's go through week... What are we at? Week 9 of the games. We had Thursday night football with Jets and the Texans. And man, oh man, that's the only game that actually surprised me the most this week. Texans losing 13-21. Garrett Wilson goes off. Congratulations. Falcons beating the Cowboys. not a shock there. Panthers actually beating Saints, and I'm pretty sure... After the game, the Saints pretty well fired their head coach, so...
They did, yeah.
Adios. Chubba Hubbard had a pretty good game. He had 2 touchdowns, so... Lions routing the Packers. I honestly seen that one coming. I picked the Lions to win that game, and, well, they didn't prove me wrong. 24-14. It was a damn good game. Dolphins coming away with a win with Bass's 61-yard field goal. Crazy game.
Wait, who?
27. The Bills.
Oh, I thought you said the Dolphins won, and I was like...
No, I said the Bills beating the Dolphins with Bass's 61-yard field goal. Or at least that's what I thought I said. Well, that's what I meant to say, anyway. Anyway, Bills beat them 30-27. It was a damn good game. Bengals just demolishing the Raiders, which, again, not really a surprise. Chargers beating the Browns 27-10. I wasn't surprised on that one. Titans beating the Patriots. I was a little shocked on that. It was an overtime. And all I gotta say is, what a hell of a game from Drake May. I almost said Drew Locke. Holy fuck.
I thought you were going to say Drew Brees, Drake and I was going to be like...
No, I'm not that dumb. Drake May, absolutely incredible pass to put him into overtime. If you didn't see that, you need to watch it. It is incredible. Commanders over the Giants. Not a shock there. The only shock it was such a close game. But, again, when you got division rivals, I don't care what anyone says. You can be a winless team and still beat your division rival. Ravens demolishing.
I was just gonna say the Broncos.
It wasn't even like close.
No.
And then we got the Jaguars almost beating the Eagles, which was awesome.
That would have been an upset, I think.
Eagles won 28-23. We got the Cardinals demolishing Caleb Williams. Seen that one coming. I did pick Cardinals to win that. I'm pretty sure I did.
I think you 29-9,
did. 29-9, which I was okay if they lost because my parlay was already fucked. But I was okay if they lost because we need them to lose, honestly. And then we had Rams beating the Seahawks, which wasn't really a shocking surprise. It did go to overtime. Vikings beating the Colts again. Not that big of a surprise. 21-13. And the only other surprise I had was Baker Mayfield, no main wide receivers. That guy can cook. And I said it, I don't know, how many times? Stop doubting Baker Mayfield, dude. Like, I didn't doubt him. I just don't know how, again, it always comes down to the timing of the quarterback and the receivers. I don't know how that was going to go with his two main wide receivers out of the game. So, Baker still did pretty good. They lost, though, in overtime, of course, and Baker knew it. If you watch the video on there, Baker, as soon as they said they wanted the ball, they knew their defense wasn't stopping Mahomes. Couple bad calls and missed calls on that overtime drive, but you know what? Who would have guessed it? It was all because of fucking Mahomes. There was a false start that should have been called. Very clear false start. I mean, he literally started like 2 seconds before the snap, but hey, who gives a fuck, right? Let's give Mahomes a fucking win. Again, 30-24. Wasn't a shocker, but it was surprisingly closer than expected. And I'm assuming since you're eating, do we want to go over the news before we go into next week's games then, or?
You may as well.
Before the game actually starts, because it's getting ready to start here in the next 15 minutes. Just for the record, I am picking the Ravens to win this game. They are at home against the Bengals. All right.
Hold on. I didn't do my picks yet. It won't take me long. Especially if I just do. I also think the Ravens are going to win. Because what did you say? The Bengals are bangling.
Yeah, the Bengals are bangling. Go ahead.
How in the fuck am I supposed to pick between the Giants and the Panthers?
And it's in London, so. So anyway, here's some news we have.
I thought that was in Munich.
Oh yeah, Germany, whatever. I say London is, it's just an over-the-pond fucking game. Jaguars QB Lawrence is unlikely to play versus the Vikings with a shoulder. The linebacker that was picked up from the Steelers, can't remember his name. He's actually, he requested a change from Green Bay. A trade, sorry. I said change. Almost same thing, really. Prescott's initial diagnostics on his hamstring. His hamstring tendon is partially tore off the bone.
Ew. So
He's a hurting real bad. A couple misplays, if you guys haven't watched last week's games, was you need to really watch Barkley's reverse hurdle. That was dope.
Yeah, that was cool.
We got some injury updates, of course, for 49ers. Looks like CMC was a full go at practice this week so far. So he should be back.
Woohoo! Should be back.
And I don't know if I got word on Greenlaw or not.
No, I think the last I saw, they were still... People were still wondering when Greenlaw was coming back. They're like, what about Greenlaw? And there was no update, so...
So, I just got a live feed. Christian McCaffrey, as of right now, breaking news here on the Overtime Podcast.
Oh, boy.
Christian McCaffrey is expected to play.
Oh, that's exciting.
So, I do have the injury report up here. Again, I'm not going to sit there. Isaiah Likely is out tonight. Okay. See, that says this is news. Is there no injuries for this? Supposed to be injuries on this fucking thing. Okay. Well, anyway. Here we go. Let me get the injury report up, see if there's any key injuries here real quick. And they're still not showing injuries on the website, so... What we know for sure, though, is we have... We have Dak Prescott is on IR. They did put him on IR. So he'll be out for at least 4 games. A lot of decent trades happen at the trade deadline. Let's see. Keaton Mitchell's out. Barkley is actually questionable with his back. What is going on with your mic?
I don't know. Every time you talk, it's static.
Yeah, but it's your mic.
Well, it's staticky when you talk too, so...
It wasn't static. It was like a weird...
Oh, well, you're all staticky. Weak. Although it's...
I'm blowing the dust out of the motherfucker. Let's see. Dallas Goedert is questionable. Drake London is questionable. Amari Cooper is questionable. Jesus Lord. Is there any receivers left in the league? Keon Coleman is questionable. T. Higgins is questionable. CeeDee Lamb is questionable. Nico Collins, questionable. So they have him as questionable. Okay. He had a hamstring injury. Chris Olave, which I'm going to assume he's going to be out again because he had another concussion this week. Darius Slayton is questionable. Dude, these are all fucking wide receivers. This is insane. And of course, Mike Evans is out. I mean, that's kind of a given. He's kind of fucked right now. Obviously, Godwin is also not feeling the best. There was a couple key trades over the... Like I said, over the trade deadline. Yeah, Steelers picked up a pretty damn good defensive end, Preston Smith. Because he kind of requested a trade from the Packers. He went to Pittsburgh, which that's a big one. Big. Other than that, there wasn't really a lot of Let's see if I can. I can't find any more news on it here. We had all this stuff set up yesterday, but some things happened. Because, Dallas picked up a wide receiver that nobody knows. Which that was fun to watch. Because everyone's asking if Jerry Jones is trying to throw the Cowboys under. Because he's a second year player, I believe, that they picked up. But they had he's fast, but he's kind of a nobody. Nose tackle. That was the other news I had. Chicago Bears nose tackle Andrew Billings was placed on injured reserve, torn pectoral muscle. He is out for the season. I can hear you, but I can't hear you through your mic.
Oh, I was muted. I was trying to curb my mic problems.
But yeah, other than that, there's not much more news. I mean, I can't find all the trades that happened. I had them up yesterday, but I don't know where I found them. But, all right, let's go on with week 10 games
week
now.
Week 10, yeah.
So as of you all heard, I've already picked the Ravens to win this game.
Yep. All right. You want me to go ahead and go through the rest of them then?
Yep.
Like we normally do? Yep. Giants at Panthers.
Again, it's not really at the Panthers. It's in Germany.
It's Germany, so. Yeah.
Darius Slayton being questionable. I think the Giants actually win that game.
Okay. Patriots at Bears.
I'm picking the Bears on that one.
Okay. And then we're going to skip over that game. Broncos at Chiefs.
Chiefs are due to lose one.
Yeah, but against the Broncos?
Divisional game.
Well, I know, but I don't know.
It's at the Chiefs?
It's at the Chiefs, yes.
Broncos won't win this one, but they'll win the next one they go against.
Okay. Bills at Colts?
Bills.
Okay. Steelers at Commanders? I had to think about that one. I was like,
I believe Washington did pick up a running back after. Khalil Herbert, I believe. Who was hurt. Their main one got hurt, I think. Somebody picked him up. Anyway, I don't know who it was. Listen, it's the Overtime Podcast, man. We're just here having fun. Man! Is that a 1 o'clock game?
That is a 1 o'clock game.
Fuck, I have to bet on it. I better pick right then.
You better think about this.
Washington. I'm Washington wins that.
Okay. Vikings at Jags.
Okay, Vikings at. You already know who I'm picking. The Vikes.
I was going to say the Jags. Falcons at Saints.
Falcons.
Divisional
game could go either way, but Falcons.
Titans at Chargers.
I'm picking the Chargers.
Okay. Jets at Cardinals.
I'm going Cardinals.
Okay. Eagles at Cowboys.
Well, you know what?
Uh-oh.
CeeDee Lamb plays. Here's my stipulation for this game. And no, I don't want to hear nothing about it. If CeeDee Lamb plays, I'm going to Cowboys. If he doesn't play, I'm going to Eagles.
Okay.
I might just go Eagles either way.
Okay.
Then they can't stop the run. If Barkley plays, because he's questionable.
Right.
Barkley is questionable with his back. If Barkley plays, they win the game.
Okay. The next game I had to think about as well. Lions at Texans. I had to think about that. I was like, well, I don't know about that.
I'm going a lot. Dude, I hate that I got to go against the Texans.
But you're going to go to the Lions?
I kind of hope the Texans win, but I'm going to have to go with the Lions.
Okay. And then, last but not least, the Dolphins at Rams.
At the Rams?
At Rams, yeah.
I think the Dolphins on that one.
You think the Dolphins? So, I only picked different on three of the games here. I have the Rams winning. I also have the Jets winning.
And who do they go against them?
The Cardinals. Now, that was one that I had to pause and like be like, I don't know. And I said, I'll just go with the Jets on this one because I don't know. And then I actually have the Steelers winning. I don't know. I mean, the Commanders aren't doing bad either. But the Steelers.
We're going back. Have you seen how they've been playing?
Yeah, well, I picked the Steelers to win that.
Right now, the Commanders are 4-0 at home.
Oh, shit. Well, then this will be the one they lose.
I'm not doubting it, I'm just...
So what happens if one of these weeks we both pick the same teams for every game?
I guess you got lucky then. Dude, I know I'm ahead of you in a fool.
Yeah, you're definitely ahead of me as far as the season record goes. Ugh. Okay, well that was all the games, so I'm gonna stick this right here and...
You're gonna try to remember it now. We on the NHL?
Yes. That's cool with me. I don't know what we want to talk about. What you want to talk about?
What do you want to talk about?
That's the wrong segment.
Oh, my bad. I know there's a video that you're supposed to pull up at some point.
Yes.
Yes, give me a second.
So, I'm not gonna lie to anybody. I've been a little bit AFK from the hockey.
Same. It's that Call of Duty man.
So, I'm gonna have to kind of
pussy whip.
Catch up a little bit. Because my team is now 5-5. 5-5-3.
Okay.
So, it doesn't look like my team has been doing very well.
Going through a rough patch, are they?
Oh, I'm sorry, YouTube.
Yeah, we lost 1, 2, 3, 4 in a row. God damn.
Oof. Losing streak.
Not looking very good. So.
Alright, let me get the volume to a good spot. Alright, let me share my screen.
I presume you're showing the injury.
Yes.
Yes.
Let me know when you guys are ready.
Oh, wait, I think I have him muted. Hold on.
Wow!
Wow, Murdoch!
Wow!
You left the chat last time before I could. I wonder why that mute button looks so funny.
All right, whenever you guys are ready.
Chris can say when. I'm in the middle of a COD match, so.
Send it.
Go ahead.
I've seen the injury.
Some stuff going on here on the bench down here, John. Holloway in some trouble here. Ray Borelli has him. The Blues are motioning for the EMT crew to come out here, so not sure what's going on.
He looks like he's all confused and shit.
So this was on his previous shift. Shot by Paul hit him. Ouch. You can see up around the neck.
How fast
right
do you think
shoulder,
I was going?
And in some difficulty on the Blues bench. Oh,
50 mile an hour.
Yeah, you wonder. I mean, you speculate just if there's something that the aftershock of it, but Ray Borelli holding his head extremely still here.
All right, I figured showed the video there and then. I have a couple of comments on that. First of all, the two guys that got the ref's attention weren't even on the same fucking team. So, good for them. Ref was about to make a call, was he not? And those guys came over and were like, hey, we got a situation.
What did he do? Is he paralyzed?
No, he's fine. They kept him in for 24 hours and he went home the next day.
Damn, because I, like, hit him.
Well, when Ethan first sent me the video, like, I didn't know it was an injury. I almost thought maybe it looked like he was having almost a panic attack. Because that's what panic attacks look like. You're kind of just like, whoa, like. But then I watched the injury happen and I was like, oh, shit. Mm-hmm. But no, they said he's fine. So it must have just been his body must have maybe just gone into shock a little bit.
Could have been a stunner too.
Yeah, it.
Big stunner.
Yeah. But then, yeah, they were a little afraid that maybe it crushed an artery or even did something to his vertebrae. I know it was the front of his neck, but I know they were talking about they were afraid it messed him up somewhere, which is why they were holding his head because they were just afraid, I guess. And I get it. But yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, but I made the comment to Ethan when he sent that to me and I watched it. I said, hockey has some of the best sportsmanship, I think, in the world.
Oh, 100%. They, unless you're in Philadelphia, the fans will clap no matter what team you're on if you're injured, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
Now, if you're in Philly, though, no. Don't expect anything.
Yeah, I just like when I watched it, I was like, oh, look at these. Oh, they're holding out for their teammate. They're getting, and then I realized they weren't even the guy's teammates. And I went, whoa, good for them.
That's fucking wild, dude.
Yeah.
That had to hurt. You think anything swelled up?
Yeah.
I wouldn't doubt it.
I'm sure he's probably got a nice bruise there at least.
I'd say that thing easily was going like fucking 50 mile an hour.
I wouldn't be surprised. All right. I would say, is there anything else we want to talk about for NHL?
Talk about how bad the fucking goddamn Utah's doing. Like I said, I've been watching the games. So I just, I've been.
I mean, it can't be any worse than the Pens.
Well.
Well, we are 5-5.
Oh, well, okay. Speaking of the Pens. Speaking of the Pens, can I just say Fleury playing his last game in the great city of Pittsburgh? That was emotional.
Oh, yeah.
Somebody, they keep talking about the Pens re-signing him for a day so he can retire a Penguin. And I like that, but I wouldn't blame Fleury for not doing that. I wouldn't blame him. They screwed him over big time, so I wouldn't be surprised as a last fuck you for him to be like, ha ha, no.
No, that was that was the Vegas Knights that did that to him.
Oh, somebody said that he got screwed over by the Pens too.
No, he didn't want to contact.
Oh, okay, well.
It's all less than the Pens.
Oh, well.
Yeah, he just didn't want to renew his contract. It was the Vegas Knights that just they traded him without telling him.
Oh well,
that's the best times ever, right there. That's like that's so, like in the MLB. I don't know if you guys know how that works in the trades in the MLB.
No.
Major League Baseball. You can get traded mid-game.
Oh my god.
It has happened many times.
Imagine you get traded to the other team.
So right? So how does that work?
They actually, so out of sportsmanship, you talk about sportsmanship, the manager will actually pull. So like there was one time, I can't remember who it was, but they were on second base. They just hit a ball. They ran a second base. Well, the manager called a timeout, and they were like, what's going on? Here's a guy that just hit the ball and got a double. Just got traded. So they pulled him out of the game and put a pinch runner out and took the guy out of the game so he didn't get hurt.
Damn.
He got on in a trade.
Yeah. So
if he gets hurt, well, then you're just paying all that money for a guy
who might get injured mid-game.
Well, I'm pretty sure it works is like if a team's trading to the other team, if that team doesn't pull their player, he gets hurt, they're still got to trade him, but they're going to have to pay like his...
I was going to say, yeah.
But, I mean, getting injured in baseball, it's pretty difficult to do, but you still don't want to do it. But it is fucking crazy you can get traded mid-game.
That is insane. I didn't know that.
We gotta think, there's how many games in the season for...
Yeah, you're right. They basically don't have...
And sometimes they play right back to back to back to back.
Well, I was gonna say, they almost don't have an off season. There is an off season in baseball, but it's pretty well non-existent. They might as well not have an off season.
182 games. I mean,
games. That is a lot of games.
Like I said, sometimes they're playing, literally, they're playing back to back to back to back to back to back to back. So anytime you get a trade, it's gonna happen mid fucking.
Yeah,
it might happen mid fucking game.
They have no choice in the matter at that point. But
which apparently happens quite a bit. But it's just funny to watch him come off the field, all because he got traded.
That is funny.
But I mean, the only other thing we talk about hockey is tonight's games and.
Yeah, like I said, I've been slacking.
Well, since we've been slacking, let's do something a little different. Let's just go over the standings, really.
Oh, okay.
At the end of the day, that's what's going to matter. So the Florida Panthers is in top of their division right now. They're Eastern Atlantic. Panthers are 9-3 right now.
Damn.
Then you got Toronto Maple Leafs at 7-5. Lightning at 7-6, Red Wings at 6-5, Bruins at 6-7, Senators at 6-6, Sabres at 5-7, and the Canadiens. It's so weird saying Canadiens like that. Like it's just, how do you spell it? 4-7. And then let's go to Ethan's teams, the Metropolitan. You got the Hurricanes. Damn, man, Hurricanes are kind of smacking.
They've been showing up this year to play some
hockey. 9-2. Capitals 9-3, Devils 8-5, Rangers 8-2. They're looking pretty good.
Yeah,
Jackets at 5-5. Lost my place there. Islanders at 5-6. The Penguins at 5-7, and Flyers at 4-8. At least you're above Philadelphia. That's all that really matters.
That is all that matters.
Holy fuck! The Jets still only lost one game. They're in the Central Division. Minnesota Wild 8-2, Dallas Stars 7-4, Blues at 7-6, and then Utah 5-5. Come on, boys, you need to fucking step it the fuck up, dude. God damn it!
I was saying, they were looking real good, weren't they, at the start?
Avalanche 6-7, Blackhawks 5-8, Nashville Predators 4-8. And then you got the Pacific Division with Vegas Golden Knights leading at 9-3, Kings at 8-3. This looks like it's a tougher division. Canucks at 6-2, Flames at 7-5, Oilers at 6-7.
Congratulations to the Golden Knights for finally winning an away game.
Yeah, they were 1-3. I see that. They're on a 2-game win streak. Oilers at 6-7, Kraken at 5-8, Ducks at 4-6, and the Sharks at 4-8. Good old Sharks. Wasn't that the team that we thought was gonna go? Not win a fucking match or game.
The Sharks.
Who was it that we was betting on? It was the Sharks, wasn't it?
I'm pretty sure.
It was the Sharks.
Yeah, because they beat my fucking team. Their first win was mine. Thanks, guys.
Or their only win, too.
Yeah.
But I think we got to get on to the main storyline for this week, because if it wasn't for this, I'd say we'd have to skip the podcast this week. Because, guys, you guys gotta understand, me and Alex, we're doing this. It is tough, honestly. Because I've been so freaking tired.
Yeah, I have to, like, I'm in the middle of readjusting back to my work schedule. Like, I was like, my first
we
night.
We had that week off. Yeah,
yeah, that week off screwed me over big time.
Oh, yeah, that will do that.
It was nice.
I think it would be a little different if my job wasn't overnight. If I had a regular job, a daytime job, I think I'd still be okay. But I have to readjust my body to the schedule I was on.
So let's go ahead to our main event of the evening. Beyond the Bell segment, baby. And it's a fucking banger after banger.
I have.
It wasn't a banger after banger after banger. It was at least two bangers in a row. But
so I do not. I will preface this. I do not have the preview for SmackDown and Raw for this upcoming week, only because Crown Jewel happened.
And that is fine. So let's. So what do you want to go over first?
SmackDown from last week. Let me make sure I got the right date. Yes, I do. Okay.
Well, I would hope so. SmackDown this week didn't happen.
Well, yeah, but sometimes it sometimes it does 2 weeks. So, all right. Anyways, first match was Tiffany Stratton versus Liv Morgan.
That's a hot match.
Jesus Christ. Morgan defeated Stratton.
Yeah, because some shit went down.
Oh, yeah. That got pretty heated.
Some shit went down, and I loved it.
Funny enough, the picture that the Bleacher Report used isn't even a picture of Tiffany Stratton. It's a picture of Liv Morgan and Nia Jax.
Nia Jax? Yeah, I wonder why Nia Jax. She was literally distracting the official.
Oh.
Yep.
And that kind of cost him.
Next match was Street Profits versus Pretty Deadly. With the Street Profits winning that one.
Thank God.
Well, I like Pretty Deadly.
I was going to say, I don't mind.
They're funny.
Oh, they're hilarious.
Okay. the notable moments. Pretty Deadly gave a copy of their musical to Lin-Manuel Miranda at ringside. Oh my god.
Oh, man. That's what I said. It's fucking hilarious.
They're good comedy relief.
Yes, I think that's kind of why I like them, because I don't, you don't have to take them seriously. It's kind of nice. Naomi and Bailey versus Indy Hartwell and Candice LeRae.
News update.
Ha! Indy Hartwell is no longer with WWE.
Yep.
That was, they said, what turned out to be her last match, Indy Hartwell teamed up with Candice LeRae.
That's just crazy to me. Like, you literally just see that superstar, and then they're gone.
Yep.
Well, again, what I had to say about Indy Hartwell, she was just, she's a follower. You know, she's not Candice LeRae. She's not the main person in that little tag team that they had the whole time. So, like, unless you're going to come out with your own, like, a lot of wrestlers come out with their own stuff, you know, like, hey, I want to do this. Hey, I want to do, you know, and it draws a crowd. If you don't do that, you're eventually, they're just going to say, you're wasting my time.
Right. Yeah.
Because a lot of wrestlers are their own creator. So, like, you need to be creative. And there might have been some potential there, but she seemed a little too shy, I guess. Like, you got to be outgoing and just, like, go out and do it, you know? It sucks. Right. But I understand why it is what it is. Because, like, Naomi, you can almost say the same thing about Naomi. Right now, she's starting to break out as her own, which is great. I kind of hope she keeps it up.
Right.
Yeah, I agree.
But again, she's got to be creative.
Yeah, so I found myself getting annoyed with her being, like, with a tag all the time. It's like, come on.
I love her outfits, though. Like, coming out in that glow in the dark shit. Yeah. That's pretty dope, dude.
She does have some of the best ring attire, I think.
That's what I gotta say about that.
I usually skip over this kind of stuff if it's not a match, but OG Bloodline is back.
With the honorary Bloodline member himself.
Oh my god. Sammy Usie! Oh my god.
You're an idiot.
I don't hate Sami Zayn. He's not my favorite, but I prefer him with Jimmy and Jay. I don't know. It's just a little bit more comedic, I guess. I don't know. It's just kind of nice.
It gives a good story.
It does.
Yes. It makes Sami relevant again.
It does. It does.
Literally.
Because let's just say there wasn't much happening with
Sammy. No, not really. This is at least kind of exciting. The next match was Io Sky and Bianca Belair.
It's a fatal four-way.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
Io Sky, Bianca, Piper, and Lash Legend.
Yeah. With Sky defeating the other three, so...
Guy is fucking dope. I actually do like her and
she's partner. Fantastic.
Yeah.
Who's her
Kairi Sane.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I love her. I love Kairi Sane. Or however you actually say her name.
And then I think this was the last match. Randy Orton and Cody Rhodes versus Gunther and Ludwig Kaiser.
Bye-bye, Gunter.
Yeah, goodbye.
It's the Viper.
Which Orton and Rhodes defeated Imperium, so that's good. Although, I mean, I know the three of us like Gunther, so...
I actually don't remember that match. I remember them coming out, but that... I don't remember that. Weird.
I don't mind Gunter. I think he needs to lose the title.
I don't disagree.
That's the only thing I got to say about
it. I agree with that sentiment.
Oh, I'm not.
He's
going
to have
right
a
thing.
Downfall here at some point. I know he is.
Oh, yeah. He's going to have to.
Guys, go away from me.
All right.
No away.
So now we'll go into Crown Jewel. We actually have a pay-per-view to discuss. First match was the Bloodline defeating Roman Reigns and the Usos. But
yeah,
that's when Sammy
Bloodline beat the OG Bloodline.
Yes, yes. Which then that's when Sami Zayn came out and was like the hero.
Yeah, they were gonna attack him more.
Well, hell yeah. Shocker.
So, and then Sami Zayn ended up kicking Roman in the head, and Jimmy thinks it's on purpose. And it's just a big conniption going on. So I'm excited to see what's going to happen this week on SmackDown.
Yeah, same. The next match was the Women's Tag Team Championship. Was that a championship match? I don't remember.
I don't know if it was for the champion.
Yeah, no, it was. It said the women's tag team title remains with Bianca Belair. Yeah.
Okay, though, you want to talk about me getting sick of something?
Yeah, I know.
Like, I'm just mad that they took the titles away and then gave them right back to them. I was like, really?
Yeah, because I actually like the fucking other
Fire and Dawn.
Yeah, what the hell are they called again?
I think that's it. Fire and Dawn.
They had a name. I know they had a name. Because, I remember them having a name, but I don't remember what the fuck it was called. But go on.
Next match was Seth freaking Rollins defeating Big Bronson Reed.
Oh my god, that match was so good.
It was good, I agree.
You know, Seth coming out back from injury, and that's the performance he gives us. I'm like, hell
yeah. Yeah. Yep. It was so good. Women's World Champion Liv Morgan defeats the WWE Women's Champion Nia Jax to become the Crown Jewel Champion, which I knew about this before we watched it. I knew who won the Crown Jewel matches because fucking Triple H had to spoil it.
Thanks, Triple H.
Thanks, Triple H.
It's not time to play the game now.
Which Tiffany Stratton, I hate it. She keeps coming out to cash in, and it never works out for her.
It'll work one of these times.
It will.
It's going to be on Nia. Yeah.
It will be on Nia.
That's exactly what I said, bro. That's exactly what I said. We're calling it now. You heard it here first, folks.
Kevin Owens versus Randy Orton, which that was insane. That match was just...
What match?
I know, which is why it was insane. And then freaking Randy Orton RKOing Adam Pearce.
That was awesome.
I was dying. Did you see...
I said, do it again.
Did you see Adam Pearce and what's his name? Nick
Aldris.
Yes, yes. Did you fucking see their tweets afterwards?
No, I didn't see their freaking tweets.
So Adam Pearce, I don't remember what Adam Pearce said. It was kind of funny. But fucking Nick goes, those socks, though. Because you could see his socks in the picture. I said, oh my god. Somebody said that the general managers need to have a match. And I said, oh my god.
Oh my god.
And then another great match. LA Knight defeating Hayes and Andrade.
I didn't even bother with that match. I was like, yeah, I'm sick of this.
I'm sick of that particular, like, Andrade and Hayes, but I am not sick of LA Knight.
Yeah, I still like LA Knight. I'm not sick of him, obviously.
No,
That stupid fucking.
That just that like that rivalry kind of going on. And then undisputed WWE champion Cody Rhodes defeated Gunther to become the men's crown jewel champion. And that Huh?
Which match was it?
The Cody Rhodes defeating Gunther. For the crown jewel.
Unholy Union.
Unholy Union, right. Yeah.
God damn it. It was going to bother me because I knew they had a name. Sorry, I had to look that up.
Oh. Yeah, I missed it because I was picking up a baby because he woke up.
Aw, baby. So then we go right into Raw here.
Oh, Raw was so good. Obviously, it's always better after an interview.
It is always better after.
We literally forgot to watch it.
Oh, well.
We were watching Creed. So, yeah, we missed it. I mean, we watched the highlights, which from what we could tell, it was pretty good, but
you missed old Bo Jackson. What the fuck? Uncle Howdy going after The Miz. You missed that.
I saw that.
Did you just say Bo Jackson?
Yeah, he did.
You mean Bo Dallas?
Yeah, whatever. I almost said fucking Bray Wyatt at first. That's how tired I am.
Oh, we would have been like, okay, Chris, what Raw were you watching?
Well, Uncle Howdy is freaking. He's a demonic being, so you never know. His soul living in there.
So, first match on Raw was a number one contender's battle royale.
And Livy Morgan was watching it all. Yeah, I was watching all of Livy Morgan.
Jesus.
Oh, I mean, I was watching the match.
Uh-huh.
Io Sky.
Io Sky won that, yep.
That was awesome. Which, again, I think is a missed opportunity. They should have, because Liv kind of said it herself that Jade and Bianca is going to eventually turn on each other because one's stronger than the other or whatever. I really think they should have been the last two and just, you know, heated that whole idea of it up, but whatever. Fun fact about that match, though. If you watch it, I'm almost certain and pretty certain that they were all dressed as superheroes.
Oh, yeah. I remember. Oh. I remember you saying.
Because I'm pretty sure Bianca and Jay was dressed as, like, the Incredibles. I think Selena was, like, Miss, like, Captain Marvel or
Well, Sanchez. Jade Cargill kind of looks, has, like, a Deadpool thing going on.
Yeah, that's. I said that during the match. I said either Deadpool or Incredibles.
I think they, yeah.
It's the elastic that gets me all the time. It always looks like it's going to be the Incredibles, but
Deadpool. That's fine. No, Jay Cargirl for sure was Deadpool.
But yeah, I thought that was pretty fucking cool if you watch out.
Yeah.
Because they were over in Saudi Arabia, so they obviously had
They'd be covered, yeah.
So I think that was a cool little, hey, look at us.
Exactly. Well, I mean, that's partially why CM Punk doesn't go to Saudi Arabia.
He refuses. He's spoken out about that. He refuses. Who? CM Punk. He refuses to go to Saudi Arabia.
Why?
Because he doesn't agree with their customs.
I don't blame him.
No, I don't. I don't.
Yeah, I don't agree with him either.
Nope. He said you won't see me at Crown Jewel ever because I don't agree with what they do over there, so. At least the man is consistent.
Yeah. I mean, kudos for that.
Yeah.
I mean, stand up for what you believe in.
Yep. Great. Yep.
I mean, he's not being a hypocrite, so.
No, exactly. And then, of course, after this match was all over, that's when we got to see the Wyatt Six with The Miz.
Which was fucking cool.
Yes, I'm like, Bo is killing it with that.
Yeah, he is. Bo's doing a great job.
I like how he's how he talks too. He has like the slow.
Yeah.
I can't think of the word.
I know what you're referring to.
Reminds me of Bray whenever he's talking.
So. Yeah.
Heck yeah.
We had the War Raiders beating the New Day.
Yep. Shocker.
I'm kind of glad that they brought those two, the War Raiders, back. I like them.
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
I always enjoy watching them, so.
Who are they part of again?
They were the Vikings.
I kind of hope that whole crew comes back. I love, dude. Who was that woman? What they call her?
Oh, I can't think of what they called her.
Valkyrie.
No. I don't think so.
I don't know.
What's their tag team name? The
Eric and Ivor are their names.
Let's see, I'm looking them up.
Valhalla.
Valhalla, that's what it was. I knew it started with a fucking V. Yeah, dude, I love her fucking outfits.
Yeah, her outfits were pretty freaking cool, yeah.
Like, that shit is dope to me.
And don't forget about don't forget about the antlers.
Yes!
That's what I mean, the fucking coming out with them fucking antlers and shit. It's fucking dope.
And then after all that went down, Sami Zayn came out.
And now he's Sammy Oosh.
Yes, and then that's when Jimmy and Jay, yeah.
Hell yeah, hell yeah, hell yeah.
Yeah, and then he started speaking Arabic, and Chris is like, whoa.
He came out speaking Arabic.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Yeah, but you said then he started. Well, like he was doing it afterwards.
No, I mean he was talking Arabic and.
Yeah, that was pretty cool. I ain't gonna lie. I like the next match though.
Dragon Lee versus Chad Gable.
Yep, I love that. Chad Gable lost.
Yeah.
He tried to put his feet up on the ropes and Zelina knocked him off. And Ivy Nile, dude, I'm so fucking tired of that motherfucker, dude. I'm so tired of Ivy Nile. I hope she gets her ass beat here soon.
Good things come to those who wait. And then it was our number one contender's Fatal 4-Way match for the World Heavyweight.
Was crazy match.
They did my man Sheamus wrong, but, you know.
Big Bronson Reed came out.
You're welcome.
He tsunami'd everybody. Dominic was running away and try to get an easy pin, and then pretty sure Damian finally snapped out of it.
Yeah, Damian won that whole thing, so.
Yeah, because like I said, Bronson Reed came out and tsunami'd everybody. Fucking Dominic's like, oh my god.
Oh, yeah, he was just kind of on the side, like, no. No.
Yeah, Dirty Dom jumped off the rope or whatever the fuck it is, turnbuckle.
I'm going to sit this one out, guys.
Yeah, I don't blame him.
And then then Damian Priest caught him, hit him with a fucking South of Heaven. Game over, GG's. Game over, GG's.
They always do my man dirty, though.
He'll eventually never get a title.
The notes say fans and analysts may have undervalued Sheamus for the last few years. Few consistently turn in the best match of any show the way he does. That and the Irishman is at his best at 46 years old.
Damn. Damn. That old boy old. Oh. That hill's creeping.
That's my boo.
That hill is creeping.
And then that was it. I don't have the previews brought up only because we wanted to make this fast, so.
Yeah, I think that was great. That was great.
Yeah.
Spotify. Sorry this is a day late. Hopefully it's going to be up tomorrow. If you're listening to this, then it's obviously uploaded. So, with that being said, let me go ahead. And do my bets.
Woohoo!
Let me just get everything up real quick. Oh, Jesus Lord, dude. Spotify, you're going to be here to listen to this. Cause I just want to do this real quick. If you would like to see the bets, please come over to my YouTube, which is Murdoch Gaming. Okay, Alex. You ready?
Yep.
Oh. Do you got it up?
Yep, it's up.
Alrighty, so we're gonna do again money line, and you see fucking $5 in there because dumbass didn't bet it last time. We have the Commanders winning, we have the Bills are winning, we have Vikings are winning, we have Saints or yeah,
Falcons
winning. We have the Chiefs fucking winning. I did say the Bears. I did say the Chargers.
Yep.
I did say Eagles.
Yep.
I did say the Cardinals, which that doesn't look good. They're underdogs. That's what we need, though.
Yeah.
Lions. Oh, that's the... You know what? It's an 8 o'clock game, but we'll leave it on there for suspense.
That'll be the match that screws you, I'm sure.
Yeah, well, yeah, $228 is what I figured. Ain't much, but it's honest work, everybody. So let's go ahead and send that bitch.
Send it.
Not much, but again, it's honest work. So while we're here, let's do... Anytime scores. We could do some bets for the night's game, actually. But I don't think I'm going to. Alright, everybody. Again, Spotify, if you want to watch that. That is at Murdoch Gaming on YouTube. Want to watch it live? Usually every Wednesday. Today we're a little late.
It's a little late today. That's all.
Just a little.
You know, it happens.
Twitch.tv/MurdochGamer. Hit that shit. And as always, I love you guys. Peace out. Thanks for listening.